Have you ever had the opportunity to try something different? Venture to a new place to test your abilities and push yourself to experience a new challenge of hunting? No matter the factors involved, you give it your best and reap every breath as if you'll never experience the possibility again. I know I have, many times, and this is one of those stories. When traveling to a new part of the world for a hunt, so many thoughts rush through one's mind. Did I bring the right gear for the conditions I'll face? Will I be in the right physical shape? Are the guys I'm hunting with even knowledgeable huntsmen, or do they talk big with little to hold up on their end of the commitment? Our original plan changed in a week prior to my departure, as we had planned to hunt out of a wall tent in a different mountain range. But a change in weather conditions and accessibility put us in a different region of the state. Research shows the area consists of a high population of Merriam's turkeys and a decent amount of black bears. The goal of this trip is to harvest both animals and fulfill what the guys are calling a spring mountain slam. The weather is supposed to be awful the first few days of the hunt, with temperatures below freezing and up to 2 feet of snow accumulation. And furthermore, I carry concerns of encountering grizzly bears foraging on the same slopes we'll be hunting, as they too are out of hibernation and highly populated in this area. Only the Lord knows our path ahead. It is for us to trust and to experience His plan.
I used to go where Carl always bear hunts.
That's what he was telling me.
And it's crazy good country.
Yep.
So it's the mountains, like 2 hours, 11:30.
Yeah.
They can kind of see. Which would be the southwest, east, north of us. So we're going that way, but he probably already told him.
Yeah.
We're going to the real mountains, like the other mountains would be like.
Yeah, they're, I think he was saying about like 8,000 to 9,000 feet.
Yeah. Well, plan B is not the worst, you know, we could be in a wall tent and 3 feet of snow. Plan A would.
I mean, we got flushing toilets, we got heat, showers, you know, it just doesn't feel like hunt camp. It's crazy.
We're straight up mountain hunting turkeys.
Well, we did bring the right camo for it.
So that's your...
Oh, there you go.
I'm scared to know there's birds right here. We gotta be with these horses and growling and everything down here. We just got up to the lodge this afternoon and put all of our stuff up to the lodge, ate some dinner, and then decided to go for an evening scout. Just gotta see if we can spot a bear or something. And just drove up the road. We've actually been basically hunting for about 10 minutes. We're just into it for about 10 minutes and came across two Jakes and a Tom turkey. Then we set up on them and we think they must have busted us or something. They were moving pretty quick and it's really windy. We're sitting here waiting for them to come in or make a noise. They were gobbling a little bit and then they just shut up. And just pulled out the binos really quick and spotted a bear across the valley. Well, I'm way up high on this ridge, so that's a good sign. We've only been really technically hunting for about 10 minutes. So it's been really nasty conditions. It's snowy, rainy, windy. So this is a good sign. It's supposed to snow the next 2 days. Hopefully we can keep eyes on this bear here and see how long he stays out in this meadow. Kind of the trick with bear hunting is to spot one and kind of pattern him and kind of see what he's doing. Or she or whatever it is and kind of see if they stick in that area for a while and you kind of mark the time that they're in that meadow. Pretty cool, not too bad for spring Montana turkey bear hunt. Old Pete's first time up, pretty awesome. Just spotted the bear about half an hour ago. He's way lower than what he was yesterday. So we put a galloping run to try and cover the distance. We're about, oh, I'd say about a half mile from him now. He's probably about a mile and a quarter up in some gnarly stuff. So we're mostly going uphill. He's kind of in the same rage he was last night. This is our first official day that we can actually hunt bear for Pete. He just got his tag yesterday, and he had to wait 24 hours, so he's good to go right now. Perfect timing. Wind's good. We're all alive still, so that's good. It's supposed to start really snowing, though. As long as that bear stays out in the meadow where we can see, we should be pretty good.
Or 1,293 feet.
Basically, all the way in the rain.
Disappear that easy. He's right there in the flat. There he is, yeah.
He's moving up this draw towards the border of the ground that we can on. So we're really hoping that he just keeps going. So as soon as he crosses that fence, we're gonna try and land some map down on him. We got about an hour, 10 minutes left or so. We'll get Pete his bear on his first actual day of hunting. Hopefully. If not, so cool. We'll get these opportunities very often. We're sitting in one heck of a snowstorm right now. It's cold. It's like 18 degrees.
Down and out of here, back to the truck.
Without hurting ourselves.
Yeah. It's been fun though.
Uh-huh.
Seen a bear.
Almost killed a bear.
If only he would have stayed on this side, things would have been a little bit different. Thank you.
So we just got back to where we could see the bear. It's been snowing all night and stuff, and it's snowing right now. The sun's kind of actually peeking through the clouds here and there, and we can glass from a distance. And we put the
now deeper.
We put the spotter right on the log that he was bedded next to last night, where we left him in the snowstorm. He's still on private, but it's definitely him. He's moving around in the same bed where we left him last night. So,
you know that the stump behind it. You know, not the main. How he's to the left.
Yeah.
So that stump that he's in front of, the small sub stump, there's a strip of snow below it, below the sub stump.
Right.
And he's below that. So you see a strip of white, and all of a sudden that white disappeared. Okay, part of good. The white, and he put his head like up high, and the white's gone. Now it's back.
I think what we're going to try and do is we're going to try and get permission to hunt that piece of ground and just sneak over there and shoot him if he's just going to hang out there today.
So we found, so one guy owns two strips up there. He owns this one and this one. But basically we're looking at that bear being like right on the line. Yeah, we could essentially get there right from the road.
So now we got permission to access a different place. The bear got up from his bed and moved back on to the property that we can hunt. But we got access to kind of kick off from a closer point. So we're only going to be walking a few hundred yards to get to where he last was seen. So we're hustling. We'll spend the rest of the day there. It's almost noon. Got our warm gear. It's super cold, windy, snowy.
When a hunt results in success, there is no other feeling quite like it. Especially when there are so many variables and conditions against you, it makes it that much better to be successful. Upon looking closely, One could tell this boar had endured a long winter and was physically starving. He had also seen his share of recent territorial conflict, with chewed off ears and claw marks on his hind end. I'm glad to have ended his time of suffering. We hold so much respect for these animals, and though many people fear their existence, and many disregard the taste for bear meat, this boar will feed my family and friends as we gather to appreciate the animal for far more than just a skull and hide. Over the next few days, we decided to relax and hunt for a bird straight out of the lodge. With warm food and hot coffee in our bellies, we were ready to roam the area for Miriam's. The sun began to peek through the clouds and the snow began to melt from the mountainside. We covered a good amount of the surrounding area through the snowed-in downfall. Our calls echoed through the forest, and we were able to get a tom to sound off on the private property below us. After hours of trying to pull him over to no avail, we moved on and spent the afternoon in awe of the beauty of the mountains and snow-covered forest. Though we never did call in that mountain Miriam, we did eventually find a roosted tom in town and enjoyed his echoing gobbles coursing through the evening air. That night, we discussed a change in plans. With time running out, Carl and Jake felt it would be best to move to another mountain range they often hunt that also holds an abundance of Miriams. Though there are birds here, They are mostly in town and not accessible to hunt. So moving to a more promising area sounded to be most productive, and the decision was made to move in the morning.
So we switched camps to get PETA's turkey. So we just got there, now we're setting up.
After packing and spending hours transitioning, we connected with Tommy Rye. He had been out on a hunt that morning and was successful in harvesting a nice Merriam. After setting up camp and getting our gear lined out, we took to roam the mountains in search of an active bird. The area was uniquely different, as one could tell the climate consisted of drier conditions and lower elevation than the other range that we had previously hunted. With the wind blowing hard and zero action, the boys became easily distracted. And as if in a schoolyard, they tested my faith in them with some weird root they began digging up and shoving in their mouths. Something they do for entertainment on their hunts, apparently. Later, they shared that the ancient Native Americans used the echinacea root as a pain reliever for toothaches. Something I never expected to experience, and will soon not forget the minty numbness of this root.
Pretty much brand new gun. What's this guy doing? All about his roots.
Later at camp, we discussed a plan to hunt another property where Tommy had gained access to hunt. The guys had hunted it many times successfully in years past, and know of a ridgeline where the white-feathered Merriams roost each night. From the sound of our discussions and their stories, the feeling in the air seemed as if the next day would bring a perfect mountain Merriam experience. As the flames of the fire diminished and the stars moved through the night sky, the morning could not come soon enough. Thank you.
Look at the barring on that.
Hold that thing, hold that beard out. About 9 3/4, like the rest of them.
No spur on that side.
Little spur on that.
Is that on that? That's funny. He's got a nice spur on one side.
Yeah,
kind of like that bird you shot behind the house.
Except that guy was old and gnarled.
Yeah. He didn't break that spur off?
No, it's just he just doesn't have it growing.
Huh.
Little baby spur.
That one's not too bad.
No. It's a good little 1 3/4 inch.
Good for a Montana Merriam.
America.
Yeah,
like
he should have been the country bird, right?
Didn't Benjamin Franklin, he wanted the...
Yeah, one of them. One of the founding. Well, Ben Franklin. Ben
most adaptable
Franklin
bird.
Wrote a letter just admiring the qualities of the turkey over the eagle.
Oh, bald eagle's a scavenger, the turkey's an adapter.
Yeah, and they got the red, white, blue head.
Feathers blowing. I love turkeys. Golly, man, look at that. That's some of the thickest barring I've ever seen on a tail fan.
Like a normal full mature bird, that the typical number of tail feathers that they have is 18.
6'1", half, 3/4 the other.
6'1", 8 ounces the other.
# spur tape right down the side of the...
Yep, 3/4.
Hold on, do this other one.
What are you getting? You picking it up? You getting something?
8.
I got an 8, yeah.
I got strong 8 of an inch.
8 proud. Proud 8.
Yeah. Where'd you get that string at?
My pants coming loose.
The memories of these mountains will always hold a dear place in my heart, and I am eternally grateful that I've harvested both Tooth and Spur of the mountains. And as we had discussed numerous times, we may have been the only hunter to harvest a bear in that storm and complete the Spring Mountain Slam.
Can I turn? Can I? Just wait, you're not gonna shoot unless you're gonna shoot me.
Another drop. This has been the
worst best
3 days of hunting you could ever ask for.
100 yards. I hope this feeling never goes away. Just, man.
As we left the mountains on our final day, it seemed as if we were coming out of a dream that could not escape our thoughts. It will always be imprinted into our mind and his inexperience we all will cherish forever.